Now, there are other surfaces also on the body, right? So, I have to find what is the net effect of the traction that is acting on the other surfaces too, okay. So, let us do that. Let us take the cut surface, cut body. Okay, say I combine both the acting load and the reaction load to say that there is some net force acting on the body, which is given by maybe something like this, net force acting on the body, something like that along the y direction. I combine the reaction force with the force acting on the body, okay. So, basically that has resulted in some force distribution like this, okay. Now, in this cut surface, there are three forces P, Vy and Vz, okay. Now, there are three moments also acting on this cut surface, which is the torsional moment, the My moment and Mz moment, okay. Now, what is the effect of this force onto this moment is what we are interested in finding, okay. So, basically I have to find the net force acting on this surface, okay, and then I have to find the moment produced due to this force acting there, okay. So, let us do that. What is that phase? That phase has a normal Ey, okay. So, I have to find first piece of Ey is going to be, in this case I am applying only on the top surface, I am applying only sigma yy. So, in general it will be sigma xy ex plus sigma yy ey plus sigma x sigma yz ez, okay. On the top surface, since I am applying only sigma yy, these two stresses are 0 since they are not applied. Okay. And then the net force now acting along the y direction is integral T of Ey dA would be integral sigma yy dA times Cy. This is the net force Ey acting along that direction, okay. Now, what is the moment produced due to this force? Now, I have to find the moment M, let us say M due to T of Ey, that will be integral R cross T of Ey, R is again same as before, okay. So, this is going to be integral x naught Ex, not x naught, x ex plus y naught ey, because it is at some, this section is at some y naught, okay, plus z ez cross sigma yy ey dA. I left the dA there. dA, okay. Now, what will this moment be? This moment would be integral sigma yy into x dA ez plus integral sigma yy into z minus ex, okay. Okay. So, that will be the net moment produced due to this force sigma yy acting on that surface. Okay. Now, there is no force or there is no externally applied load at the other two faces. That is, there is no external force applied on this face or on this face, right. So basically now I have to satisfy the equilibrium equations, force and moment equilibrium for this section. Okay. Now here what I am getting? I am getting a Fy, I am getting a force Fy here, and I am getting a moment Mz. I have to use a different symbol here. So let us use M tilde Z, and I am getting a moment Mx tilde at that face. Okay. So okay, now equating the moments, we saw that there are two components of moments due to the traction acting along the x direction, that is Mz moment plus Vy into x naught. This is the total moment component along the z direction for the traction exposed on the x surface. Okay. So you will have Mz plus Vy into x. Okay. Say this distance at a distance x plus Mz tilde has to be equal to 0. This is moment equilibrium along z. Along z direction. Okay. Similarly, force equilibrium along y will tell you that Fy plus Vy has to be equal to 0 for force equilibrium along y. Okay. Now, force equilibrium along x direction would tell you that P has to be equal to 0, and then force equilibrium along z direction will tell you that Vz has to be equal to 0. Okay. We are not bothered about the other two moments in this course, but anyway, for completeness, let me write those also. The moment equilibrium along x would imply that T plus Mx tilde has to be equal to 0, and moment equilibrium along y would imply that My tilde will imply that My plus Vz into x must be equal to 0. Okay. Now, from this force equilibrium, I get the condition that Vy is minus f of y. Recollecting what f of y was integral sigma yy dA, and here dA is sigma yy dz dx. I split the area integral into what the area integral is, and this we by definition was qy dx. Okay, where qy is defined as integral sigma yy dz. That is, if I have a cross section, this is y and this is z, and I have a varying sigma yy along the cross section, I integrate that over z and I get the effective load that is acting per unit length of the beam. Okay. This is qy dz. Okay. So, from here I get, using this expression, and using this expression and this expression, I get that V y is minus integral q y d a, q y d x. Okay. In other words, this implies that d v y by d x plus q y is equal to 0. Okay. Now, let us go to the first equation. We add m z plus v y into x plus m z tilde equal to 0, and here m z tilde was integral from here, m z tilde is integral sigma y y, here from here m z tilde is sigma y y into x d a. Okay. So, we will do that, sigma y y into x d z d x. So, this will be integral q y x d x, again using the fact that q y is defined as this. From this fact, I will get this as q y x d y. Okay. So, I get the equation. From here, m z plus v y x plus integral q y into x d x is equal to 0. I differentiate this equation, differentiate star with respect to x, what do I get? I get d m z by d x plus v y plus d v y by d x into x plus q y into x is equal to 0. Okay. From this equation, this I can rewrite it as d m z by d x plus v y plus d v y by d x plus q of y into x equal to 0. Okay. We saw that from the force equilibrium, this has to be equal to 0, and hence we get the second governing equation, that d m z by d x plus v y equal to 0. Okay. So, what you have seen today is, you have seen two governing equations for beam bending. One is this, and the second one is d v y by d x plus q y equal to 0. Okay. Here you have to note that v y is nothing but integral sigma x y d a, and hence the positive v y is this. This is a positive v y, and q y is given by integral sigma y y into d z. Okay. And hence q acting upwards is positive q y. Okay. Similarly, for the mz moment is integral sigma xx into y dA with a negative sign. Okay. We will see in the next class that this will imply that this is the positive mz value. Okay. Essentially, what we have done is, we have taken a beam, we have cut a section, exposed the traction, and then we wrote the global force and moment equilibrium for the acting forces on the beam and the exposed traction. From that, we got the governing equations for how the bending moment and shear force will vary along the axis of the beam, okay. This Vy is called as the shear force and Mz is called as the bending moment. Okay. So, the next class we will take it forward and see how the deformation of a beam will take place. From the deformation we will write the strain displacement relationship, constellation, one dimensional, and then use the equilibrium equations again to solve for the unknowns. Okay. The things to take away from this lecture is these two governing equations. The things to take away from this lecture is these two governing equations and the fact that you have the 6 equations, right. Out of the 6 equations we simplify the first 2, the other 4 you have to carry over for the next lecture, okay. Thank you.